What's going on, everybody, and welcome to the channel. Today we are checking out the KingKong Tiny 7X. It is a 75mm ducted fan style tiny hoop by KingKong. Now, I have already done a review of the Tiny 6X and the Tiny 8X, and I have the Tiny 6X right here, so put it side by side for a size comparison. Now, the Tiny 6X has a 65mm frame, and it comes with these 7/16 sized brushed motors. Now, the Tiny 8X, which I have here as well, so let's put those two side by side for a size comparison. Now, the Tiny 8X has a 85mm sized frame, and it comes with these 85/20 sized brushed motors. So the Tiny 7X comes in right in between these two. So let's put all three of them for a size comparison here. Whoops. Just like that. So it comes in right in between, and it is the middle brother. Now, so it has a 75mm sized frame, and it is sporting the 8/20 sized brushed motors. And all of these have these plug and play type motors, so no soldering is required to swap out the motors. Now, the Tiny 7X comes with these 40mm tri-bladed props, and they give you three full set of extra props, as well as the props that are already on the quadcopter when you get the advanced version, as well as three batteries and a battery charger, a multi-battery charger, I might add. But the basic version will have just the props that are on the quadcopter, and it just comes with one battery and a single battery charger. Now, it is also available as a ready-to-fly version that comes with a remote controller, and the remote controller looks just like this. Now, my Tiny 6X was a ready-to-fly version, so I have this remote control, but we'll have just one set of props on the quadcopter and with just one battery, just like the basic version. Now, it's got a SP Racing F3 flight controller with a built-in 16-channel 25mW VTX, and here is the VTX antenna. It is just a single strand copper wire for the VTX antenna. It does the job, but it will not give you very much distance on your FPV feed. And the FPV camera is an 800 TV line, 150 degree field of view, fixed angle FPV camera that is snapped into the canopy, and the canopy is screwed onto the frame via a couple of screws, one on each side. Now, the frame on these Tiny X series are really tough, and they can take some abuse. They got these reinforced side bridges between the ducted fan guards, and the plastic that they use gives a little, so it won't break that easily either. Now, the flight controller has a couple of buttons, if you can see those buttons right inside there. The one on the left is for the boot button for the flight controller, and the one on the right is to change channels for the VTX. So all you got to do is just single press that VTX button, and it will circle through those 16 channels of the VTX. Now, the model that I have here came with a FlySky receiver, but it is also available in the Spectrum receiver version, as well as the FrSky receiver version as well. All right, so here is the plastic container that the quadcopter came in. Now, this will be the advanced version, so it comes with all kinds of stuff. Now, it is a little different of a plastic box than the Tiny 6X or the Tiny 8X. The Tiny 6 and the 8X came with a little carry handle. It was like a little briefcase looking plastic container, but this one is a little different. It has another compartment on the lid itself, so you open up the little compartment and it has all of the accessories, like the prop removal tool, and we also have a couple of battery cables, extra ones, just in case you happen to rip out your other one on the quadcopter. We got a set of white props, we got a set of yellow props, and we also have a set of red props, and we also get a bag of goodies, and it contains some grommets for your flight controller, as well as the screws, and we are given some extra rubber band to secure down the motor wires onto the motor, and we are given some different color canopies, one red one, white one, and a yellow one, so you can change the color of your quadcopter entirely using these canopies and your different color props as well. And here's the instruction manual. It is in Chinese on one side and in English on the other side. It is a multi-use user manual for the tiny 6X, 7X, and 8X as well. And if we open up the bottom compartment of the plastic case, which is pretty hard to do, there's the quadcopter. Now the quadcopter came with a rubber band slung all the way across, so the quadcopter did not move around. And here are the batteries, and they are the LDARC branded 450 milliamp batteries, high voltage, 4.35 volts, and the advanced version will give you three of these batteries. Now, it also comes with this little LED light battery life indicator, so which is nice. You can check what your battery level is out on the field. And here is the multi-battery charger. Now, it is a built-in to the container multi-battery charger. You can power it up utilizing a micro USB, or you can use an XT60 connector to power that battery charger up as well. Now, I believe when you use the micro USB to power up the battery charger, you can only charge up to three batteries on this side, I believe. And if you power it up utilizing the XT60 connector, you can charge up to six batteries at the same time. Now, it already comes prepped for high voltage charging, but you are able to bridge those two pads and you can make it into the regular normal voltage battery charger as well. All right, so let's go ahead and measure all of the quadcopters. Here's the tiny 6X. It comes in at 26 grams. So the tiny 7X will come in at 35 grams, and the tiny 8X will come in at 40 grams. So to bind the quadcopter to your transmitter, you just hold down that bind button. If you can see that little bind button on the receiver, so you just hold that button down, maybe with a screwdriver, and power up the quadcopter. That will power up the receiver at the same time. You can use the provided battery that comes along with the quadcopter and just plug it into the battery cable, or you can also power up the flight controller, which in turn powers up the receiver utilizing the micro USB port as well. And once you have done that, the receiver will go into the binding mode, and at that time you're just going to hit that bind key on your transmitter and you should be good to go. Now, the quadcopter already comes with angle mode selected, so you can go ahead and take off right then and there, or you can also select some modes in Betaflight. Now, this quadcopter supports angle mode, horizon mode, as well as acro mode. So let's go for a little demo flight with the KingKong Tiny 7X. All right, here we go with the test flight of the KingKong Tiny 7X. I got it bound to my original jumper T8SG remote, so let's go and check it out. There we go. Yep, sounds like a KingKong product. Very similar in sound to the 6X and the Tiny 8X. So this one has a brushed motor, the 8mm by 20, that is right in between the size of the 6X and the 8X. So it's got pretty good power here. You can fly this thing outdoors. Oh, there's a little bit of a jerky motion. I think I got my rates up a little bit too high for this thing for outdoor purposes. There you go. But you are able to fly this thing outdoors on a calm, windless day like today. And what a beautiful day today is. One of the rare days this winter, or this February. It's been a very wet winter this year here, and very windy one as well. So it is nice to be flying a tiny hoop 75 millimeter outdoors here. Yeah, it's doing pretty good. Nice speed. Let's do a little speed pass. There you go. But this thing is made
to be flown indoors. Yeah, I'm just spinning out of control because my yaw rate is a little too high. There we go. All right, let's see if I can flick it over to acro and perhaps do a little flip, see if it has enough power. Oh yeah, it's got nice power to recover from a flip. So let me bring it in. I went really high that time just to be on the safe side. There you go, you can do flips with this thing. Yep, it's got enough power. So the question is, do these brushed motor tiny hoops have a place in our hobby anymore? Because so many brushless tiny hoops are coming out. 1S, 2S, some 3S, and now some with 4S capability. And, you know, they have all these state-of-the-art flight controllers with OSD, and they even have RSSI, smart audio. Some even have telemetry now. So I feel like I'm flying something that is back in time, because this thing doesn't even have OSD. So I don't even know what the battery level is when I'm flying it with my FPV goggles. So let's go ahead and bring it in for a landing and test it out with the FPV goggles and do some FPV. There we go. Okay, so here we go with the FPV flight out here in the field, and there is a little bit of static here and there because the VTX antenna is just a single copper wire antenna, but the Tiny 7X handles really well since there is no wind at all, and it could be a good starter FPV slash acro trainer since the slightly larger motors than the Tiny 6X do have a decent amount of power. But if you really want a tiny hoop to fly at your local park and the conditions are not optimal like it is out here today, where there is absolutely no wind at all, I would recommend brushless tiny hoops like the Mobula 7 or even the Emax Tiny Hawk, which handles acro flying a lot better outdoors. But if your thing is to fly indoors, I'd much rather have a brushed motor tiny hoop since the power is just right for indoors. And one of my favorite size is the 65mm tiny hoop like the Tiny 6X, since you can really push it and it is not overpowered for indoor flying. And this Tiny 7X for me still has a little too much power for a small indoor space, but with a slightly larger indoor space, the King Kong Tiny 7X, I think, can really be a very fun tiny hoop to race around, and it is just perfect for indoor FPV flying. So that is it for now for the King Kong Tiny 7X. Thank you so much for tuning in and watching. Have a great day, and we'll see you again next time.